So if I may ask, Anga, then in the last calendar year, roughly what was the number of complaints that you all handled as part of the committee?
So we have looked at around two to three complaints in the year 2019. But there, I would like to mention about one complaint which we could kind of, take it to a closure, and we could actually finish the inquiry. So that complaint was registered by a student of a university pursuing her further higher education. And she had actually reached out to a physiotherapist for some ailment that she was having, some orthopedic ailment. And the physiotherapist, while giving physiotherapy, had touched her, but she was not clear about it, whether it was a sexual touch or whether it was a part of the treatment. But what happened after that was that he started sending her. So they connected on Facebook, and he started sending her messages on Facebook, which is when she spoke to her university, and the university was aware about the local committee as a mechanism. And more so, she did not want to approach the police because she didn't want her family to know about it. She came to us. And we, the clinic of that particular professional was in our jurisdiction, and that was his workplace where she was taking his services. So we could summon him, and we could conduct inquiry, and then we could also recommend a penalty. So this was to do with a self-employed professional. So I would also like to say that the local committee purview, though not categorically mentioned in the Act, but also extends to self-employed professionals. So, like a doctor's clinic, or say in this case, a paramedical professional. So I'm sure there are several of these kinds. There could be chartered accountants, there could be engineers, lawyers. Where the person is either functioning on his own, or there are maybe one or two employees along with him. And I think this number must be huge, because the categories that I just mentioned, many of these professionals are self-employed.
Absolutely. I think for the benefit of everyone who's going to be watching this, I want to mention that under the law, the Sexual Harassment of Women at Workplace Act, there is a provision which states that if there is a workplace which has less than 10 workers, they do not need to form an internal committee as such. Complaints for any of those kind of workplaces can very much go to the local committee. So that is what Anagha is referring to, that if a person is self-employed, let's say there is only one person, say a sole proprietor kind of a thing, where they are managing their work on their own, or have say two or three people with them, anybody which is any number which is less than 10, then all of those complaints will automatically fall under the purview of the local committee. And of course, if the location jurisdiction also permits.